Hi, I'm Nicki Micheaux, one of the stars of Lowlife, the movie.
It's fantastic to have you here at Fright Fest. What does it mean to you to be a part of this year's festival?
Yeah, gosh, I guess it means that my career's turned out all right. It feels pretty good. I mean, it's definitely, to come all the way to London in Europe and premiere a film that you're proud of, it's an incredible experience. I am super happy about it. Well, you know, honestly, it started, it's funny because Ryan says, I want to pitch you this movie. I go, Ryan, you don't have to pitch me. I'm going to do it. He goes, well, let me tell you. I go, honestly, Ryan, it's you and me. We're good. So, I mean, I knew they liked the Anarco Corrido, the short we did before. Basically, I was kind of a badass with a gun, which is so much fun. I love doing that kind of role. So we wanted to recreate that feel. But what I liked about this was, you know, she just wasn't a blanket, you know, badass with powers and super ability to shoot for no reason. Like, we really tried to humanize her and make her a full person. So that was really what drew me to it, because it wasn't just walking around Nicki with a shotgun. There were a lot of layers to the character that I had to find, and that was really fun. And also, I was curious how Ryan was going to solve some of the challenges of the script, because this is a mashup of a bunch of genres, and there's really, I don't know what to even compare it to, honestly, because it is unique in itself. So I was very excited to see Ryan's vision come to life and really just be a part of it. I play Crystal, and I'm a recovering addict. I gave my daughter up long ago into a very bad situation, but I wasn't really aware of it. So when we start the movie, I'm trying to get a kidney from my daughter to help my dying husband. And that's when I find out that she's basically been sold into the sex trafficking organ harvesting ring, and I decide I have to go rescue her. And I end up teaming up with some very unlikely characters to do that, and everything just kind of goes awry. So that's, and comedy ensues, as I like to say. It's more of a crime caper, and I think that, you know, I just think that because the thing of it is, the characters are all really real. They're all real people, sort of. But when you really ground yourself in those characters, you can, some people are just funny, so now you're in a comedy. And some stories are more dramatic, and then other stories are more a little bit on the superhero side, a little bit even. So I think that it's the truth of the characters and the full developedness of them that allow you to have a story that ends up kind of weaving these genres in and out. And I think that's also what holds it together, because it's not like, and we're just going to smash up some genres and make a movie. It was, no, we're going to take these characters and put them in the same world and see what happens. Ryan and I are talking about, of course, Lowlife 2. But we're also working on a couple of other things that are pretty cool, and we'll see what happens with those. But I do have, I worked on a movie called Lazarus that's going to come out on Netflix, so that's kind of dope. But always auditioning, and catch Animal Kingdom on demand. Check it out, season one. Lazarus is a superhero movie, and I'm the one who discovers this man who's got these powers, and I don't want to say too much else about it. So that's kind of it. But it's really cool, and it's an opportunity to another superhero that's created from scratch, so that's fun.